Welcome. We are so delighted to be here with you for the Eco-Conscious Music Alliance Global Action Concert. We are thrilled to be part of Peace Week, an international planetary-wide alignment of changemakers just like you and hundreds of organizations coming together to unite our hearts and our actions to co-create a thriving world for all. Today, together, we will be sharing amazing music from musicians around the world to activate and inspire us. And we bring that into action by co-creating community sustainability projects all over the world, which is EMA's mission and the Eco-Conscious Music Alliance. It is our mission and our honor to serve and support you. We'll be introducing many ways that we share that support and would love to offer it to you. I'm sitting here with hundreds of packets of seeds to share and an abundance of beautiful musicians who have gathered. I want to invite us to take a deep breath, to feel our roots deep in the earth, to feel the living earth rising up through us, we who are all part of the living earth. And as we breathe, we find the regenerative power of the earth flowing through us in infinite creative unfolding. With our hearts open, we turn to the shining sun, breathing in the golden light that activates us all, activating our love, our caring and compassion. We align our whole one being in harmony, peace, and well-being. With hands to the heart, we can feel our heartbeat. And the love within us awakens with each heartbeat as the waters of the world nourish us and connect us. We also are offering this session today to the wellness of the waters as part of Peace Week's honoring of the waters today. And I want to invite us to feel the pulse of the one body of water that's moving through us with every heartbeat. And as we share our love through the waters of our own bodies and our actions, we bring about the wellness of all of our world through this one body of water, what many of our teachers call first medicine. Thank you for being here with us today. As we begin our music, I am so happy to be able to introduce you to my dear friend, Will Taylor, who is here in Austin, Texas. And Will is a legend here in the Texas area. He works with countless hundreds of musicians on a project called Strings Attached, bringing together music and healing and wellness. And he's recently brought this into nature therapy, into nature connection with his new project, Strings in the Woods. And we'll be seeing that video next. Thank you.
Well, hey, everybody. I'm Will Taylor, and this is Charles Pruitt, my good buddy, who's been part of Strings Attached for many years. We're really excited to be a part of the Eco-Conscious Music Alliance broadcast today. We're here in Mary Moore Seawright Park, And one of the projects that I do is I take people out into nature and let them hear acoustic music, the way the music has been for most of the time that it has existed on Earth. We love reminding people that great music and nature and these small communities that we build by taking folks out into the woods is a great thing. We're big champions of teaching people about what we need to do to care for the earth, about slowing down and resetting our nervous systems out in nature. And by doing these acoustic music concerts with strings in the woods, it's called the project, we find that people really enjoy themselves, even when a plane flies over. All right, here's a little melody we'll improvise around called Simple Gifts. And pretty much everything you hear, about 90% of it, is just made up right here in this beautiful spot, improvising. Thanks for watching.
And so much thanks to Will. I hope you're all feeling the beautiful waters and sound activated within you. If you want to know more about Will Taylor, his website is willtaylor.com. And he does so much support caring for the people on the planet, including going on an incredibly regular basis to our senior housing and low-income senior housing here in Austin, and supporting people in their healing throughout the lifetime. We're honored to have him as part of our EMA community. And I'm delighted to share with you that next we are going to be featuring music from Eric Rabaska, who so many of you know and love, from Light Warriors. Eric had planned to be here live today and is not able to. We are sending healing and love to his family. And we're grateful to have a set that he shared with us to share for you to enjoy. But let's just take a moment. I know so many of you love Eric. Let's just take a moment to send him our support and our love today, as he so kindly has supported so many of us. Thank you. And we are ready for video. I want to thank John for hosting us today. Thank you, John Raymer.
For sure. Yeah. Now, we do have something of Eric, but I thought next was June.
Oh, I didn't run right away. Yes, go right ahead and you can play both. I wasn't ready for the transition between them. That's perfect. Thank you so much.
Okay, you want to do June next. Okay.
June is just an EMA intro.
Okay, all right. I want you to do what you want, so hold on. Give me a second and I'll bring it up.
Beautiful.
I want to make sure it's not wobbling for anybody. So if I don't go full screen, let's see how that goes. It's played and fine on Facebook.
We really are one earth, and that's beautiful. And we can do so many positive things with that. And it's so powerful.
The Eco-Conscious Music Alliance mobilizes positive change through music.
This movement that is taking climate action, fostering sustainability, and raising awareness.
Pandemic response and online concerts.
Supporting communities, diversity, sustainability, and above all, Mother Earth.
Because it just feels like we're all so dedicated to this change, and music is such an important part of it.
Growing food and growing a revolution. So if you'd like to join us, please head over to EMA.earth. We welcome you with open arms.
Should we just jump right to Eric?
Absolutely. Thank you.
Okay. Was it all right without it being full screen like that? All right, let's go.
It was 1:36:01. On a day when the sun was eclipsed by the moon. Darkness falls, danger lurks around. When will we solve for these broken rules? We hit extinction levels, for we see it's only us who can help us. As the roots are destroyed by persistent abuse, nature taking over, changing the tune. Sometimes life can make us so sad. But still minds recognize ourselves. Still minds recognize ourselves. So we gotta raise the frequency, higher spirit. Raise the frequency, higher spirit. Higher frequencies, raise the spirit. frequency, bringing love into action. Bringing love into action. Bringing love into action. Bringing love into action. We got these maze of emotions, they make the focus go hazy. Paralyzing thoughts of time, still remembrance when I was a part of a world meaning something. And there's infinite potential, it's spiraling within these darkest emotions that control it. So inject compassion on traumatized hearts, and to depend on our natural arts. Sometimes life can make us so mad. Quiet's disrupted. We recognize what we have. Recognize what we have. So we raise the frequency, higher spirit. Raise the frequency, higher spirit. Higher frequencies, raise the spirit. Raise the frequency, bringing love into action. Bringing love into action. Bringing love into action. Bringing love into action. Suffer from PTSD. All these whims of misinformation causing divisions. We're on two sides of the same coin. Time to look through untainted prisms. Damaging mistakes repeated over thousands of years. Break free the vicious cycle. Live a moment without fear. What we want now? No more division. No more division. No more division. You got the strength to speak your peace and deal with consequences. When we beat our fists against the wall, are we beating down heavy resistance? Consciousness can't stand taller than these mountains of convention. We can stop the misery, move forward, take some action. What we want now? No more division. 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 No more division.
Enjoy it.
angles break down and cry. Is it a lie? All these times we ask ourselves, why do we cry so much? All we try to do is get across our own point of view, doing the best we can to listen, try to understand all these things that we do. Is everything eventually fits neatly in a place? In disgrace, bringing anguish to our face. Will we catch our broken hearts and just hide in a safe place? Is everything eventually fits neatly in a place? There's always some need to fight for control in the face of loss, never fully comprehending consequences of action at all cost, till long past the healing for lost souls, sad melodies blow. Yeah, it's time to relax, time to relax, and just let it all flow. Secrets on our shirts, exposing them to the grime and the dirt, but not sheltering ourselves just to avoid being hurt. No, no. Everything eventually, everything eventually, everything eventually fits neatly in a place.
Go. And Lisa's coming back. There she is.
So special. Thank you. We're feeling that together. So grateful to be together in a space of peace today. You know, when we are creating peace, we're really growing the world we want to live in. We're growing ourselves. We're creating culture change, we're healing our planet and our communities. And it all starts with that peace in the heart, that love, that innate sense of connection and caring. I want to share with you an offering from the Eco Conscious Music Alliance. As many of you know, our focus is helping people create community sustainability projects wherever they live. We say, uniting in music, arising in action. We're raising up the energy with music, and then we're channeling that energy into creating projects that serve the people and the planet. And we started here in Austin during the winter storm several years ago. We were able to, when the city was shut down with ice for a week and power was down and people couldn't get out or get any supplies, we were able to deliver thousands of hot meals to the doors of many of the most vulnerable in our community with focused service on communities of color, low-income BIPOC neighborhoods. From that, we started working in cooperation and community with leaders in those neighborhoods. And we started helping grow food and plant food that would be shared for those who are experiencing food scarcity. As we continued to expand this project and also helping groups in other parts of the world with their projects and brainstorming together, we found that one of the problems people were having was actually getting seeds started at these community serving gardens, because they were all volunteer powered and they often had little resources to get someone in to water several times a day, sometimes even to have access to good water, reliable water resources, was really difficult. So we, at a global action concert, just like this one, at our community action session, which is the second part of this event. We start with music, and then we invite you to join us in Zoom to actually vision and take action to create projects. We were debriefing on what challenges people were having when we heard about this watering seed starting issue. So right there, we innovated what we now call our Foster a Community Garden project. And I'll invite John when you're ready to, if you can show slides, and I'll talk a little bit about it. They can just flow. It doesn't need to be an exact timing. And thank you for that, John. So we started inviting people to come and gather with us at this community action session. And we actually have a slideshow of the Foster a Garden project. And what we did with that is we partnered with, here in Austin, we have many public food forests, and this is one of them. I'm grateful to be able to be on the board of the Festival Beach Food Forest. And we put together trays with upcycled and donated materials, and we invited people to come and plant a tray. And they could take home that tray to foster it, to water it and care for it, and then bring back those plants and plant them at community serving gardens. This is some of us at the Festival Beach Food Forest. We also planted at the Workers' Rights Alliance, at a number of BIPOC leaders' homes where they share and focalize community. And we're so grateful to be able to be growing food throughout the year here in Texas, and also helping others wherever you live to create a project like this. Would you love to help feed people in your community? Would you love to grow food and garden with people where you live? These plots can be at community gardens. They can be at someone's backyard. We've recently created a starter kit that we're going to be helping people who get involved with EMA to have all the tools, the instructions, and you saw we had lots of different ways of setting this up so we could track who planted what and match them with gardens. We're going to teach you how to do that. We also have seeds. So many, many, many seeds to share with you. And we would love to be able to do that. We're very grateful to the Great Outdoors store here in Austin, who have donated hundreds of packets of seeds to help us share as part of this project. So the way this works will be shown at our community action session today. And I want to invite you to register at ema.earth. You'll be sent the Zoom link that starts at 4 o'clock Eastern. And we're really looking forward to sharing with you. We'll also have some people from projects that are currently going on talking about their work. And I want to let you know that your support really makes this possible. So even if you're someone who's not thinking, I want to join a project, but I would like to help. Well, you can actually help by donating. And we want to invite you, if you feel called, to share some support to help us send seeds, because the more money we actually have to mail these seeds, the more we can send them not only in the US, but outside. Thank you so much. You know, we really can grow a thriving world for all. And it's up to all of us to be part of becoming good ancestors, creating this thriving world for the future generations. And I'm so honored to work with young change makers in the rising generation now, who are climate activists all over the world. And Our educational partner is Sustainable Living Guide, which is an online platform for education, for positive change, personal, community, and environmental. Generation Earth is the Sustainable Living Guide's youth branch, which has been created by and for people in their 20s and teens, because we all know that climate action is so important right now. It's essential for us to understand the timeline that we need to create change on, which is very quick and it's unprecedented. And yet we're coming home to ourselves. We're coming home to our wholeness. We're coming home to the vast majority of our human history, where we lived in deeper connection and devotion with each other and with the living earth. And we're co-creating that now in the world that we live in, the world that calls us into action, into love in action. Generation Earth was started here in Austin by the founders of the Youth Climate Strike, who at the time were in high school, by interns from a Sustainable Living Guide, and by many of the leaders of the local youth climate groups at colleges and in other organizations. We're going to show you a brief video that they recorded and put together of the climate strikes here. And then we're going to tell you about the evolution of this project and how those of you who are in your 20s or teens or have loved ones in your 20s and teens can come and be supported by an offering that they are about to launch. Thank you.
Having the climate as something in your head that you're like considering with every decision that you make. I mean, the climate impacts almost everything. Just think, is this sustainable? And if it's not, try to find an alternative.
What do we want?
Climate justice!
When do we want it?
Now!
What do we want?
Climate justice!
When do we want it?
Now!
I'm here today striking for our future. I'm frustrated with all the inaction that takes place within our government, within institutions of power.
Anyone? To strike, be a voice for people who can't be a voice here right now, for people in other countries, for people in other situations that can't be here today to speak for their land and their environment. I want to stand for that, for them, up against the people with privilege who think that they understand that perspective and they don't.
Why are you out here, Lauren?
With climate change, the polar caps are melting and the oceans are rising, but we are also rising.
And then as I learned more and as I, you know, continued my training in science, I realized that thinking of the impacts on the planet and the impacts on people separately is impossible. They are linked, right? And for many people, they might not care about what's happening to the polar bears or to habitat. They're that insulated from reality. But they will care very much about the effects on their lives, about what's going to happen to their health, their livelihood, their societies. And so it's important in terms of reducing human death, reducing suffering. It's also important to kind of build understanding so that everyone acts on this.
Dreaming is an essential part of making a change, and the best dreamers are us. Kids who have an awesome idea and wake up to write it down in our notebooks, or see a problem in the world and help brainstorm ways to help solve it.
We rely on oil companies too much, and we need to stop that because we can switch to renewables easily.
It is a human rights issue, and it's impacting people all over the world, and it will continue to get worse until we reach a tipping point.
Be the voice of the great granddaughter, saying climate justice now. We're gonna rise like a water, we're gonna call this crisis down.
Empower them to act in their own self-interest, you know, to give them the knowledge and the tools and the opportunities to actually do something about climate change in the immensely privileged position that I hold. I mean, there's so many people that don't have the opportunity to do the amount of work that we all do, that don't have the access to resources, access to education, access to time, to transportation, to so many different things that I'm fortunate enough to have the ability to do. And so I felt like it was my duty and my responsibility to actually try and make this world a bit better.
And our youth's future is important, and our youth need to be heard, and we need to continue to support and stand behind our youth when they're asking to be heard.
The reason for striking is that literally everything could end if we don't. There's a threat of mass extinction, and it could happen as soon as 100 years, 200, but it's still going to happen, and that's the scariest part of it.
When people propose solutions where we try to modify the climate on a large scale, so for example, if we do things like try to seed substances into the upper atmosphere to reflect more energy of the sun back into space, in theory that sounds great, but we don't have a test lab, right? We have the one planet, we have one experiment, and those sorts of technologies make me very cautious about our ability to predict what would happen.
Climate change is such an urgent issue because not only is it a climate change, but it's actually a climate crisis as well. We want our world 50 years from now to have the same species and for them not to be extinct, for people to be able to have just a beautiful world as we do today. And so right now we're trying to change and reverse the damage that has already been done to our ecosystem in order to do that. There's one saying that I always say, which is don't be discouraged by life's little stings, but get back up and spread your wings. This right here is a sting. But this amazing march and this amazing strike is one way that we are getting up and spreading our wings. So definitely be sure to look online, do research, find out ways that you can help support this cause and that we all together can get back up on our wings.
Isn't it amazing what we are able to learn from our youth? I want to give honor and respect to the young change makers that are coming up all over the world and helping us all recognize, understand, and most importantly, take action, take impactful action to mitigate the climate crisis, as well as help with adaptation support, especially for those who are most vulnerable in front lines, climate communities, and marginalized communities. I'm very excited to be able to welcome Holly Harwood, and I'll invite her to be spotlighted and come on stage with me. Thank you so much for joining us today, Holly. Holly Harwood is a 20-year-old Vietnamese-American climate justice activist, and she really was born into this and, you know, considers herself a lifelong activist. She has been very, very active since she was 16 and has done just amazing things so far. And we're very, very excited to have her as part of Sustainable Living Guide's team and community. Holly is coming in. One of her roles is being the lead on an amazing climate action initiative that invites young people from around the world to get involved in local action in an innovative way and with the support of the Sustainable Living Guide. And as Sustainable Living Guide founder, I have the honor of mentoring her and Eliana and many other people that many of you have met. So Holly, welcome. I'm so happy you're here today. How are you?
I'm doing great. Thanks for having me. It's an honor.
Thank you. As we begin, I know we're going to be talking about the project and letting people know more about it, but I think it's appropriate. You know, we often talk, and I'm speaking this to the older folks my age and such in the community. Leading from behind is such a powerful way to lead with to mentor these climate activists, these young rising generation, because they're more on it than we ever were. And I've been an activist since I was 16 and with Marching on Washington as an elementary school student. So before I ask a couple questions, I just want to give you the floor to say anything you would like to our global community around climate and taking action.
Yeah, I think being a young environmentalist activist, I feel inclined to share how much weight the climate crisis has on our shoulders as young folks. And as Lisa said, supporting us from behind and giving us the tools and resources to like make our dreams come into fruition is what I hear a lot of young activists seek from the older generation. So just having our support and giving us a seat at the table when we can is really appreciated for young activists.
Thank you. So with Generation Earth, with Sustainable Living Guide's Youth Branch, we're putting together a program to give them support, to give these youth activists and would-be youth activists, people who care but don't know how to make a difference in your generation, or maybe they haven't found their people. Maybe they really know, but they haven't found their people to connect with. And we're helping them with that. Can you tell us about the project and what it will do?
Yeah, of course. So right now, the youth branch of Sustainable Living Guide Gen Earth is creating a climate action impact project. And this project's origin was from members of Austin Youth Climate Strike and other local climate groups. So this is their idea from people who are in their 20s to teens. And so we're creating this project for other youth activists. And our essential goal is to amplify youth impact and climate projects and support them from behind and give them resources and kind of give some structure when planning any project trying to create lasting impact. So we're trying to create, rather than just awareness, we want to create impact that can trickle into their future projects. And our central demographic in this whole project is going to be youth-run climate organizations, organizations in universities, or independent climate activists. And we're going to give them the tools and outlines to kind of support them in their own local initiatives. So we're going to help them look inward and whatever local means to them, whether it's in their county, their city, in their country, and kind of work with them and work alongside them to make sure that their project gets fulfilled the way that they want to. So we're offering that support on the side.
Thank you so much. That's, you know, it's going to be an amazing year to bring this together. Can you tell people if they were going to get involved, what might they expect? What's going to happen in the next couple of seasons? What are some of the highlights of the support they'll get, the type of project they might work on, and the events that they'll be invited to?
Yeah, so With Sustainable Living Guide being established for a long time, we have a lot of tools that we can integrate to this project. So we want to give organizations and also like climate clubs kind of like the scope of different ways that they can act and make impact. So whether that be environmental justice or agriculture or water system. So we're going to give them different ideas and scopes for them to kind of channel their own passion and kind of see what they are called to act on. And once they kind of get a grasp of where they want to direct their passion and energy towards, we're going to give them a starter kit, which will help them brainstorm and connect their passions to creating a lasting impact. So not a lot of clubs or organizations can identify a problem that they want to attack immediately. So we're going to help aid them through different presentations and prompt questions, and help them create a plan of attack, because it is very intimidating going into a problem and trying to see what angle should we go about this, and also supporting them, whether if they need equipment or editing software or any mentor support, we're going to be there beside them. And we're going to create different, and we're going to give them daily check-ins every month. So it's not like we're going to give them this template and they're going to run with it. Every month, we're going to have multiple check-ins with each group and organization and say, how's this going with your group? Are you guys moving in the way that you guys want? How does this feel to you guys? And we're going to help them level up their project beside them. And hopefully when they feel ready to launch their own projects, we're going to amplify it on our social medias and get people supporting them and interacting with them through our social medias and watching their project grow, which is going to be amazing to see. And our ultimate goal by next year is to share their successes and to share their learning outcomes in a virtual, I would say, kind of like a science fair. So they're going to share, this is what we accomplished in this 4 or 5 month span, and kind of share and celebrate their wins. And that's kind of what we want to create. We want to create confidence and mentorship and guidance to these activists who are doing amazing things already.
Thank you. Thank you so much. You know, it's amazing to me to see what we can do when we come together. And can you share I think we're going to just share the email. Let's share it in this public forum and people can contact us. Can you tell the email that people can just, we haven't publicly launched this yet. Y'all are getting the sneak preview. You'll see it on social media towards the end of Climate Week. And I hope everyone is paying attention to Climate Week at the UN this week. Can you say where people should email and just let us know you're interested and we'll start you on a process of learning about the project and getting support?
Yeah, of course. So you can email us at genearth@sustainablelivingguide.org and we'll set you all up and get you guys onboarded and let you know the information and kind of be there for you guys if you get interested.
Fantastic. Thank you. So genearth@sustainablelivingguide.org. Awesome. Wonderful. Well, we look forward to connecting with you all. And for those who are not in that Gen Earth generation, 30s, under 30, how can you help? We'll have lots of ways for you to help, from mentoring to sponsorship to coming to events and learning and supporting these amazing young people. So feel free to drop them an email. They want to talk to you too. Holly, thank you so much. I really appreciate your help. And you know, this project wouldn't be possible without you and without your peers that we're getting to work with. And I want to really, you know, speak to that for everybody listening. I run a business. Sustainable Living Guide is a business. I have shared my business to create a youth climate platform because this is the time, this is what we need to do now. And I want to invite those of you who have a business, who have a nonprofit, who have a platform and a sphere of influence to share your platform. When we go to the Sunrise meetings and we ask the Sunrise Movement, how can we help you? First thing they say is share your platform. So I want to encourage everyone, share your platform and especially come into action following the lead of these young people. Holly, thank you so much. Appreciate having you on today.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody.
So we have some amazing music coming up. We're going to share with you first a little bit more about the Eco-Conscious Music Alliance. You can see that Ema and Sustainable Living Guide work real close together.
The best thing about music is that it is the commonality that brings people together.
What a joy to be part of a global community rising. I'm going to invite you wherever you are to take a breath and feel how we are sharing this sacred air, this sacred moment, this sacred time on the planet to come together and come into action from our hearts, growing that thriving world for all, the vision of our heart's highest vision for a thriving world for all. And you know, music helps us activate our ability to creatively envision what's possible. So we're not only facing the challenges before us, but we're moving from the limitless potential within us. And I'm excited to next introduce Heidi Little, who is one of the Eco-Conscious Music Alliance family musicians and a big part of We the World and our Unity Earth community. Heidi is a singer, songwriter. She has advanced training in social emotional learning and brings the performance arts to support people to heal their hearts, help heal each other, and heal our world.
Hi, everyone. My name is Heidi Little, coming to you from Smithville, Texas. I am so honored to be here celebrating the International Day of Peace with you, the 11 Days of Global Unity, and the Eco-Conscious Music Alliance. And I just want to touch on love and freedom and truth and continuing to stay loud in these times when everyone I know has a challenge going on in their lives. And I just want to send my love and my care and my respect to you wherever we are meeting in this moment and however we are meeting in this moment. It really is a beautiful thing to be alive, and I had to force myself to count the gratitude today with everything that's going on around me and all the people who require support. So my projects and my work in the world has always been for peace, for love, for unity, for community, for family. And I'm going to sing a song for you today that was inspired by and co-written over a decade of ideas and hopes and dreams for our family with the man who made Woodstock, Artie Kornfeld. And it's called The Spirit of the Woodstock Nation. So let's start there.
Beauty is in the eye of the beholder. We have seen so much. Angels.
And as we consciously choose to put our attention and our focus on growing our love and on supporting each other and being here for each other, we are changing the world. And I meet gorgeous people everywhere I go, beautiful people, all walks of life, all backgrounds. And I want to thank you for showing up in the grocery store, in your work, at your home, in your car, wherever it is that you are in this moment, and just touching in on that heart and breathing in the love and breathing out the love. My favorite thing to teach my students is that it's like tap shoes for your heart. You can't be in a bad mood when you've got them on, when you've got it growing on, and we're consciously breathing, consciously working in our world. And you have to forgive me, I've been an educator and a musician my whole life. I can't not do it. It's just me. And hopefully you love me too. Because I know I love us, our humanity, you, me, the world. And working with the waters and the Mother Earth and all our relations. And I am headed out to a gathering in the Black Hills, the songs and stories of the peoples, to decolonize, to create, to co-create. It's good to come to this place, into a space of safe and brave space and of love. And I have to speak these words in these times when there are so many opposing what only makes sense for our happiness, for our joy, for our health, for our wellness. And I want to honor and thank everyone who's come before me who has stood for peace, everyone in this moment who is on this planet with me standing for peace. And God bless your work in the world moving forward. And may you have all your needs met, everything your heart desires, and the blessings rain down upon you. So thank you, Lisa Pavati, for Unify, for We the World, for Unity Earth, for International Children's Month, for the medicine we are all bringing and holding the space that we've been holding. Okay, I'm going to play the song One. Also for you. Ba-na-na. Life is real.
forests, the oceans, the rivers.
Ah, what a gift. What a gift, this music.
With white.
Yes, I saw the video stopped, so yeah. I'm jumping in.
Sorry, Lisa. Do you want to go back to the room? There's a few seconds left of the video.
That would be great. Let's hear Heidi. Okay. Thank you.
Hang on. Here we go.
Light footsteps of grace. And ease, and love, and good health, and prosperity. When we take care of our Mother Earth, she takes care of us. That song was given to me in 2009 when I asked the planet what she needed us to hear. And that's what she needed us to hear, that we are one with her, that we are one in the mission, the collective mission, to take care of our beautiful home, and to take care of our beautiful selves. And then hopefully having enough room and time in our lives to take care of each other and to serve in some good way. So whatever your gift is, may right now it just expand in your heart and in your life. And whatever your mission and your purpose here on this planet, may it just land for you. And if it's already landed, may it exponentially grow and flourish and blossom and bloom. And I thank you, and I thank you. All right, so my name is Heidi Little, and I've been here in love with the Eco-Conscious Music Alliance and World Peace and Prayer Days in June, but which we also take care of that, June 21 every year, and the Children's Global Wave of Love and International Children's Month. But right now, 11 Days of Global Unity, September 21, International Day of Peace. May we lay down our inner weapons so that we are able to lay down the real weapons. And our love is more powerful than the people who are sick here. And I think that that's where we need to place our focus on this day. Our love is more powerful. Love is more powerful. Try it. And if you're doing it, aho. Blessings on your journey. Thank you for having me. Peace and love.
Ah, yes to peace and yes to love and yes to music. Thank you so much, Heidi. To find out more about Heidi Little's work and music, you can find her at HeidiLittle.com. And I'm excited. We are actually performing together at Medicine for the People next weekend. So if you are in the Texas area, come on out and join us live. Speaking of live, we have our beloved friends Clan Dyken joining us today. And I have loved these people as well as their music for so many decades. I am just beyond excited and delighted whenever we get to connect. They're getting set up. They are so kind to be joining us today. They're just literally getting off their tour bus. And Clan Dyken are based in Northern California. They are a family. And they've inspired us with things like bike-powered tours and their incredible service to the Diné people, to the Navajo Nation, their service to the earth and caring for the people in their community and caring for the most vulnerable, like those experiencing homelessness. Today, they have a new video that they are releasing, and we wanted to share our Peace Week space with them to share this amazing video as well as a live set. They're going to be talking with us a little bit too. I'm going to check if you can get your sound on. Do you want to talk before we show the video?
Okay, can you hear us?
Now I can hear you. Ooh, and I can see all the way around. I feel like I'm dancing now already. We're spinning just a little bit. Thanks for setting it up.
Yeah, we don't want to give you vertigo.
I love to spin. I'm good. Those who've ever seen me dance know I'm usually doing that. Well, welcome, y'all. Thank you so much for joining us today. Do you want... Oh, I'm hearing a... is my audio on in your space? I'm hearing the echo.
Yes.
We can turn it down a little bit.
Yeah.
Can we get a full screen here for us?
So how are y'all doing? You're just getting off the bus. Everybody feeling good today?
Yeah, awesome. We feel great. We had a great time last night up in Nevada City. Wonderful show outdoors. It was beautiful. Got dusted with a little rain this morning, so we're feeling pretty good.
Always a blessing.
Back. We made it just in time. You know, sliding into home just under the tag. We made it, and we're happy to be here.
Thank you. And I think if you push out your camera a little, we'll see everybody. We're seeing 2.5 people and a guitar. There you go.
Yeah, I can't get the little top screen to go bigger.
Yeah.
So I can see
Would you all like us to show the video while you finish getting set up? I don't want you to feel rushed or anything. We could show this video and then you'll tell us about it, or would you like to tell us about it?
Yeah, that's probably the best way to go. I mean, Lenora can just tell you a little bit about it before you go.
Great, go
Nora's
for it.
Working the camera right now. She can turn it towards herself.
Hey, hi. Nora. Hi, nice to see you.
Thank you, you too. I was just in a natural position to be the video documentarian, and then this idea came up to do a music video, and Silas Dykett and I edited it, and some magic was born for Good Morning Grandmother.
Magic is born. Here we go. Yeah.
not surrender. Go to the altar and give it up, surrender. Surrender, surrender, surrender. Nothing is what it is. Nothing is what it is.
We're breathing that morning light together. Thank you so much for waking up our hearts with such sweet sacredness. Oh my goodness. I played this video yesterday when we received it, and then I played it again, and then I played it again, and a couple more times, and I still couldn't help but dancing as we heard it now. And I hope everybody out there was really, really enjoying that. Wow. And what a treat to have a live set coming up too. Thank you guys. Do you want to tell us before you jump into music about your work and your presence on the planet? You know, I think some of my inspiration for starting EMA really came from your modeling through the years. And I just have so much love and gratitude for you all. Can you tell people a little bit about what you do?
What did we do? I forgot. We grew up always believing that music had the power to make things. And so all of the music that we play and the way that we play it is an art form, but isn't just about that performance, but the lifestyle and the work of making this a better place to live. It's all tied into it. And then the experiences inform the writing. And this guy has written songs, and it's, you know, you'll listen, and it's all based on our life experience. So we don't have a lot of boy meets girl yeah 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 songs. We have songs like that, which is just all influenced by our contact and our ability to connect with the indigenous people who we take a lot of direction from or inspiration from. And I've long believed that they have answers to questions that we have asked. So our 30 some years, we've been traveling down to the land of the domain, doing our annual BBA illness supply run. We do a tour to support that, and we bring support to elders to place. Basically, for us, pre-location since the 1974 Hopi Navajo Settlement Act, so they could have more space to expand the world's largest coal strip. The time is really connected there, and we spent a lot of time at the test site on a lot of our music and that afterwards. So we've been fortunate to be able to have that.
We also, on our path, have had some mentors. Wavy Gravy took us under his wing. We did a tour across the country for Nobel Prize. And we learned a lot from Wavy Gravy about putting on shows and making commitments about, you know, the intentions behind what we do. And also, Fantuzzi, whose birthday was yesterday, was another guy who
writing songs, playing songs, interacting with audiences. Just bringing a positive vibe. And just a little bit before that, folks who don't know us, Bear and I are brothers, and we've been doing music together since forever. Today, we're fortunate to have our really dear friend, Chris Osworth, who played a lot with us. That's the same.
Yeah, music. Thank you for all that you all do. I'm gonna let you know the sound was just, we can hear you, but it sounded a little far away. So I'll put, I know you're you've got your lovely tech here working the camera. I'll put a message into Zoom if we have any trouble hearing on the music so she can see it. And we've got about 15 minutes. So grateful. Thank you.
Well, this first song is our cheerleading song for Greta Thunberg. Who I was just told yesterday, people who even have heard of them are more likely to be involved in climate or have climate awareness. So we just like to do our little part in cheerleading for Greta Thunberg. That's why I say, go get a breath, go get a breath.
Hey guys. Hey, I have a suggestion. Whoever's got that phone in their hand and is you're on Zoom, right? Do you guys know how to turn the original sound on as opposed to off? What's happening? Zoom will noise cancel. They're trying to make it so that the person speaking, because they're not used to people playing music, so this is a particular setting. And the person's got the phone in their hand. You see, there's a little
speaker on. Okay.
We really want to hear you. It feels great. Just can't hear it the way we want to.
Okay. Does that make a difference? Does that help you? Because now we can't hear you, but we can hear him through the phone.
Holy shit. That makes a huge difference. Okay.
Did that work?
A lot better. Yeah. Now, I don't know. Let's see. Maybe bring the volume down a little bit. Play a little bit more.
Let's see. Bluetooth connected, so I can unconnect that. Okay.
I turn it back landscape so we get a full view.
No, it's not connected there yet.
We can see you and we can hear you. You can just turn it back to the horizontal.
Right. That's good.
Golden.
Now, it might be a little loud. Let's see her. Just play a little. Yeah.
There's someone speaking, but I can't tell what they're saying. Can you hear them, Lord?
Barely.
Should we play one?
Yes. Yes,
okay.
Yes.
Okay. All right. This song is called Migrantes, which means migrants. Should we start with the... Yeah.
Now I lay me down to sleep. Pray, Lord, my soul to keep. If I die before I wake, pray, Lord, my soul to take. Migrantes. 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 Pick up your tent, pick up your bags, pick up your heart, mama. It's time for us to walk on. Across so many lines, we left it all behind. We never know what we find. Migrantes. 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 Asylum seekers, we are refugees, running from violence and poverty. We've come so far, following the star. A better life for our families. Migrantes. 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 Now I lay me down to sleep. I pray the Lord my soul to keep. And if I die before I wake,
migrantes. 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 Everybody comes from somewhere. When you're vulnerable, you only hope someone will care. Look into the face of the human race. There goes your eye, but for grace. Migrantes. Migrantes. Migrantes.
Just gorgeous.
Okay.
Gorgeous. Thank you.
All right. We got one more for you.
Got one more quick one.
And perfect. Thank you.
Lisa, you were friends with Harai, right?
Love to Harai. Yes.
Okay. Well, this song, we call it Brother Harai. We also call it Wish the Best.
Thank you.
That's one of the last things I witnessed from Harai. He's the guy who first taught me some reggae strums, and we did some agricultural work in Southern California, planting organic date trees, and we camped out in the desert. Over the years, I learned a lot from Harai, and the last thing I learned from him was he was in the hospital just before he died, and this song, he tapped out the rhythm on his meal tray, and he sang this song, and I added some words to it, so... This is our tribute to Brother Harai. I was a mighty singer, big heart, belly that bringer. He always had some music in his hand. Words that he said, I wish the best for everybody. I wish the best, yes, I wish the best, yes, I wish the best for everybody. I wish the best, yes, I wish the best. He said, I hope to wish the best for you. Best for me. It's all the same. Have to change the game. Drop the duality. Well, I wish the best. Everybody, I wish the best. Yes, I wish the best. Yes, I wish the best. Everybody, I wish the best. Yes, I wish the best. Said the mother, we only have one. Don't circle around the sun. The same, let's change the game. Have ourselves a lot more fun. Well, I wish the best. Everybody, I wish the best. Yes, I wish the best. Yes, I wish the best. Everybody, I wish the best. Yes, I wish the best. Everybody, I wish the best. Yes, I wish the best. Yes, I wish the best. Everybody, I wish the best. Yes, I wish the best. I wish the the best. Yes, I wish the best for everybody. I wish the best. Yes, I wish the best. I wish the best for everybody. I wish the best. Yes, I wish the best. Yes, I wish the best. Everybody, I wish the best. Yes, I wish the best. Yeah. Yeah.
Yes. Thank you. Wow. And so much love to Harai and the legacy of love that is singing strong, still and always. Thank you for that. Gorgeous. Yes. So I want to welcome Ben. Thanks for being here, Ben, for coming on in. Thank you so much, Clan Dyken family. We love you. I want to encourage folks who are hearing Clan Dyken, some of you for the first time perhaps, to check them out at clandyken.com. Dyken is with a Y. And
Clan with a C.
Clan with a C, like community and caring. And is there anything y'all want people to know about this new video or anything else you'd like to share?
Well, these last two songs are on a new album that we're working on, which we hope to release soon. So stay in touch for that. And we just launched a YouTube channel with that new video. So we'll start populating that and just have some exchange with the world. And if folks are interested in any of the projects, we love to hear from people. So thank you so much, Lisa, for the work that you're doing and spreading this kind of music and love.
Love you so much. And we look forward to being of support on our live streams and with hands in the soil in all kinds of ways together. Look forward to connecting and being of support in the work that you're doing. Thank you so much for joining us today. And folks, we'll be sharing lots of whatever Clan Dyken's do, and we'll always try to let y'all know. Thank you. Love you guys. Breathe deep, this sacred love, this beautiful love that unites us and connects us, that enlivens us and that we arise with. I want to invite everyone to, I want to invite everybody who's listening, who's circling, who's joining us today to bring that love into action with us at the Eco-Conscious Music Alliance, as we're helping people create community sustainability projects wherever they live, wherever you live, right where you are. And we're going to be meeting today in about 10 minutes in a Zoom room that you can come into with us. If you're hearing this live, if you're hearing the recording, just get in touch with us and we'll connect you in. But if you're hearing this live, in 10 minutes, we are going to be meeting in the EMA Zoom and inviting you to join us as we talk about how can we support you with your community sustainability projects, perhaps ones that you already are growing, or perhaps you're inspired recently to bring your love into action, whether that's growing food, planting trees, caring for the water, sheltering those who need it, coming together to truly grow that flourishing, thriving, peace-infused world that we all hold in our hearts and we're visioning together and bringing into form. At the Community Action Session today, you can register to come to the session at our website, ema.earth, you'll receive a Zoom login link so that you can log in. But to get that link, you need to sign up, please, at ema.earth. And we're going to be talking about the Foster Garden Project. For those who weren't hearing this earlier, we have hundreds and hundreds of packets of seeds to share. And we look forward to helping you learn more about how to start seeds for community gardens, even if you don't have a community garden, a community serving garden, a garden that's being grown for food to give away to those who are in need, because truly we're all one family, and food and kindness and connecting with the earth and each other is a beautiful way to live that family, that unity consciousness that we all are. We're going to be sharing
one more artist before we sign off. We're going to hear a song from Wazy Heart Sound. And Wazy is an amazing musician, a Zambian musician from Africa who works to serve the people and the planet, but water is actually one of her main causes, and that's how we met her. And today, of course, with Peace Week, we are honoring the water. So thank you to Wazy.
In Nyanja, here in Zambia, Nyimbozako means your songs. So whatever it is that you are passionate about, whatever it is that you want to speak about, I'm encouraging you to voice it up. Nyimbozako.
Thank you. I want to just give so much love and appreciation to Wazy Heart Sound and to all the amazing musicians and guests that you heard from today. You can find out more about Wazy on Facebook, which is /Wazy, W-E-Z-I, Heart Sound. And our hearts are sounding out. We are feeling so much love and connection. We're going to be opening our community action concert next in the Zoom room. You can register at ema.earth or send a message through the website if you have any trouble with that. You can also contact us at connect@ema.earth. So if you have any trouble getting into the Zoom session, just reach out to connect@ema.earth, where we are headed over to talk about the Foster a Community Garden Project and how we can help you grow food in your community. I want to thank all of our musicians and speakers today and on our other streams that have been so kind and generous. I want to give out so much appreciation and to support for Peace Week and Unity Earth, to We the World, and especially John Raymer, Ben, and the team. John, thank you so much for coming in and making the tech magic and the love magic happen for us and literally y'all, thousands of other people this man is bringing together with his tech wizardry and heart spirit. I also want to really give appreciation to Cecilia and Tsukumi, who are part of our intern team, who helped us make this event possible. And of course, every single person who's involved with EMA projects for community, and attending our live streams, spreading the word, and living your love in action. We are truly one global family. We love you. I invite you today to hold your water with love, and feel the healing of the planet as you drink it in and enliven the love in your heart, activating the waters of the world to our peace.